not much you could do or say to faze me. People think I'm a little bit crazy. I get it from all angles, even occasionally Doc Dre's will have to step in every once in a while to save me, to make me stop and think about it before I just say things. Sometimes I forget what other people just make think. A lot of rappers probably wouldn't know how to take me if they heard some shit I later take for to erase me. I may be a little too fast paced and racy. Sometimes the average listener rewinds and plays me 20 times cause I say so many rhymes it may seem like I'm going too fast cause my mind is racing. And I could give a fuck what category you place me, long as when I'm pushing up daisies and gone, as long as you place me amongst one of them greats. When I hit the heavenly gates I'll be cool beside Jay-Z. For every single diehard fan who embraced me, I'm thankful for the talent in which God gave me, and I'm thankful for the environment that he placed me. Believe it or not, I thank my mom for she raised me in the neighborhood daily to jump and chase me. It only made me what I am today. See, regardless of what anybody believes who hates me, you ain't gonna make or break me trying to strip me of my credibility and make me look fake. G, you're only gonna be in for a rude awakening, cause sooner or later you haters are all gonna face me. And when you face me with all the shit you've been saving to say to me, you had all this time to think about it. Now don't pussy out and try to about face me, cause I've been patiently waiting for the day that we finally meet in the same place to see.
No matter how many battles I've been in and won, no matter how many magazines on my nuts, no matter how many MCs I eat up, oh, it's never enough. No matter how many battles I've been in and won, no matter how many magazines on my nuts, no matter how many MCs I eat up, oh, oh, it's never enough.
My flow's untouchable, now you gotta face it. Uh-oh, it gets worse when I go back to the basics. You go say the wrong shit and get your whole face split. The smell of victory, love it so much I can taste it. I spot my target, blaze a direct hit. Crazy, you peace talk, save it, your shit sounds dated, Jehovah, rated on my blood. Get it up, study your moves, then crush you motherfuckers. If I'm the best and the worst, then God's gift is a curse. Soldier trained to destroy, you paying attention, boy? I spit shit, slick shit, so quick you miss it. To be specific, I go ballistic, it's hieroglyphic. My music is a drug, press play, you ain't gotta sniff it. Shoot it or pop it, roll the bag of the chopper. To get your high over and over, but you gotta cop it. When it's hot, you're hating, it's undeniable, stop it.
No matter how many battles I've been in and won, no matter how many magazines on my nuts, no matter how many MCs I eat up, oh, it's never enough. No matter how many battles I've been in and won, no matter how many magazines on my nuts, no matter how many MCs I eat up, oh, oh, it's never enough.
Father, please forgive me, for I know not what I do. I just never had the chance to ever meet you. Therefore, I did not know that I would grow to be my mother's evil seed and do these evil deeds.
Mama had a baby and its head popped off.
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 My mama don't want me. The next thing I know, I'm getting dropped off.
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 Ring, ring, ring on the doorbell, and the next door neighbor's on their front porch.
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 But they didn't want me neither, so they left me on someone else's lawn.
Else's lawn.
Else's lawn.
Else's lawn.
Till somebody finally took me in, my great aunt and uncle Edna and Charles.
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 They were the ones who were left in charge.
My elementary day gang up on me and sang this song.
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 It went a little something like
Mary had a little lamb, little lamb, little lamb. Gabby had a Satan spawn, Satan spawn. Mama, why do they keep saying this? I just don't understand, understand. And by the way, where's my dad?
Father, please forgive me, for I know not what I do. I just never had the chance to ever meet you. Therefore, I did not know that I would grow to be my mother's evil seed and do these evil deeds.
Predominantly, predominantly, everything's always predominantly, predominantly white, predominantly black. Well, what about me? Where does that leave me? Well, I guess that I'm between predominantly both of them. I think if I hear that fucking word again, I'ma scream while I'm projectile vomiting. What do I look like? A comedian to you? Do you think that I'm kidding? What do I look like? Some kind of idiot? Wait a minute, shit, don't answer that. Why am I so misunderstood? Why do I go through so much bullshit? It sucks bullshit, it's touch more bitch. What was me? There goes poor Marshall again, whining about his millions and his dancing and his soul he's always drowning in. And the dad that he never had, and how his childhood was so bad. And now his mom was a dope addict, and his ex-wife, how they go at it. Man, I'd hate to have it, as bad as that Mr. Mathis claims he had it. I can't imagine it, that little rich poor white bastard needs to take some of that cash out of the bank and take a bath in it. Man, if I only had half of it, if you only knew the half of it.
Father, please forgive me, for I know not what I do. I just never had the chance to ever meet you. Therefore, I did not know that I would grow to be my mother's evil seed and do these evil deeds.
Evil deeds, while I plant these evil seeds, please release me from these demons. I never had any of this shit planned, Mom, please believe. I don't wanna be Satan's spawn, never got the chance to say I'm sorry. Now look at all the pain I caused, dear Santa Claus, why are you not coming this year again? What did I do that was so bad to deserve this? Everything could've been so perfect, but life ain't a fairy tale. I'm about to be hoisted up in the air, 40 feet below me, there's people everywhere. I don't even know but to feel like they know me, cause I'm in this Ferris wheel, and all I wanna do is go to the mall and take Haley on the carousel. Without this crowd everywhere I go, but life is like a merry-go-round. Here we go, now do-si-do, now curtain's up, the show must go. Now ring around the rosy, the show's over, you can all go home now. With the curtain just don't close for me, this ain't how fame was supposed to be. Where's the switch I can just turn off and on? This ain't what I chose to be, so please God give me the strength to have what it takes to carry on. Till I pass 50 back to the baton, the camera's on, my soul is gone.
Father, please forgive me, for I know not what I do. I just never had the chance to ever meet you. Therefore I did not know that I would grow to be my mother's evil seed and do these evil deeds. Father, please forgive me, for I know not what I do. I just never had the chance to ever meet you. Therefore I did not know that I would grow to be my mother's evil seed and do these evil deeds.
Even though I hold the weight of the whole world on my shoulders, I ain't never supposed to show it. My crew ain't supposed to know it. Even if it means going toe-to-toe with the Benzino, it don't matter. I never drag them in battles that I can handle unless I absolutely have to. I'm supposed to set an example. I need to be the leader. My crew looks for me to guide them. Some shit ever does pop off, I'm supposed to be beside them. That Josh said I tried to squash it, it was too late to stop it. There's a certain line you just don't cross, and he crossed it. I heard him say Haley's name on the song and I just lost it. It was crazy, this shit went way beyond some Jay-Z and Nas shit. And even though the battle was won, I feel like we lost it. I spent so much energy on it, honestly I'm exhausted. And I'm so caught in it, I almost feel I'm the one who caused it. This ain't what I'm in hip-hop for, it's not why I gotten it. That was never my object, for someone to get killed. Why would I wanna destroy something I helped build? It wasn't my intentions were good. I went through my whole career without ever mentioning it. Never just out of respect for not running my mouth and talking about something that I knew nothing about. Frustrates, homie, stay out. This wasn't my beef, so I did. I just fell back, watched and gritted my teeth while he's all over TV. Now I'm talking to a man who literally saved my life. Like, fuck it, I understand. This is business, and this shit just isn't none of my business. But still knowing this shit could pop off at any minute. Time when you could just say a rhyme and wouldn't have to worry about one of your people dying. But now it's elevated, cause once you put someone's kids in it, the shit gets escalated. It ain't just words no more, is it? It's a different ballgame. You call names and you ain't just rapping. We actually tried to stop the 50 and Javi from happening. Me and Dre had sat with him, kicked it and had a chat with him, and asked him not to start it. He wasn't gonna go after him until Josh started gapping. In magazines how we stabbed him. Fuck
it. Smashing, mashing him, let him have it. Meanwhile, my attention's pulled in another direction. Some receptionist at the source who answers phone to this desk has an erection for me and thinks that I'll be his resurrection. Tries to blow the dust off his mic and make a new record. But now he's fucked the game up, cause one of the ways I came up was through that publication. The same one that made me famous, now the owner of it has got a grudge against me for nothing. Well, fuck it, that motherfucker could get it too. Fuck him, man. But I'm so busy being pissed off, I don't stop to think that we just inherited 50's beef with Murder Inc. And he's inherited mine, which is fine, ain't like either of us mine. We still have soldiers that's on the front line, that's willing to die for us as soon as we give the orders. Never to extort us, strictly to show they support us. Or maybe shout them out in a rapper up in a chorus to show them we love them back and let them know how important it is to have Runyon Avenue soldiers up in our corners. The loyalty to us is worth more than any award is. But I ain't trying to have none of my people heard or murdered. It ain't worth it, I can't think of a perfect way to word it. Then to say that I love y'all too much to see the verdict, I'll walk away from it all before I let it go any further. But don't get it twisted, it's not a plea that I'm copping. I'm just willing to be the bigger man if y'all can quit popping off at your jaws with a knocking. Cause frankly I'm sick of talking, I'm not gonna let someone else's coffin rest on my conscience.